In this screencast, we will discuss the concepts about the control valve, one of the most important pieces of machinery in our control scheme. The control valve, as the name indicates, is controlling the flow rate. It is often controlling the flow rate in a control scheme of the value that we are manipulating in order to meet our particular control specification. So as an example, if we were talking about a heat exchanger, and we were trying to control the temperature of our process fluid, what we would be manipulating in order to get that desired temperature is a flow rate of, for example, cooling water. So to get a particular outlet process fluid temperature, that would correspond to, via using an energy balance, a particular flow rate of cooling water. Thus, it's important that a control valve is able to adequately control in the range of interest. This range of interest will be dictated by the process. So whether or not we would need 50 to 200 GPM of cooling water to satisfy this, or 25 to 75 GPM, would be dependent on the various specifications of the process. The design equation for the control valve can be represented by the following relationship, where Q equals CV multiplied by F multiplied by the square root of delta PV over G sub S. Now, let's go through what each of these variables represents. Q represents the flow rate of whatever fluid you have. Delta PV represents the pressure drop. It's not the entire pressure drop across the entire process. This is the pressure drop across the valve only. And this can become important a little bit later on as you are trying to appropriately size a valve. GS represents the specific gravity. CV represents the valve coefficient. And the valve coefficient is an explicit definition. It represents the amount of water that passes through a fully open valve when the pressure drop across it is a standard value. Depending on your units, this can be different, but typically one example of a standard value would be 1 psi. The final value, F, is known as the valve characteristic. And the valve characteristic is related to the lift of the valve. In other words, how open it is. And in a simple way, the valve characteristic can be represented as the ratio of the actual flow rate going through divided by the maximum flow rate. So we're going to talk a little bit more about the lift in just a minute, but an important point to note about this equation is that it is only valid for liquids. The reason why it's only valid for liquids is because of the fact that gases being compressible, that causes an issue with the fact that we would need to know more information about the gas, particularly PVT information, in order to appropriately size the valve. Whereas in this equation here, we're assuming incompressible liquids, so therefore it doesn't really matter the type of liquid we have, or its temperature and whatnot. So broadly, there are three categories of valves we have: linear, equal percentage, and quick opening valves. These three valves are differentiated by how their flow rate is related to the aforementioned variable of the lift, which is a representation of the fraction open the valve is. So a lift of 0 would indicate a fully closed valve, and a lift value of 1 would indicate a fully open valve. So for linear valves, they're designed such that the flow rate is directly proportional to the lift. In other words, how open it is for a constant pressure drop. So therefore, as you double the openness of the valve, you go from 40% open to 80% open, you are doubling the flow rate going through. So what this means is the fact that the valve characteristic F is proportional to L, the lift. So where this L here represents the value of the lift. For the case of equal percentage, we have the case where there is an equal percentage in change in flow for a particular change in the lift. So in other words, what that is saying is the fact that dFdL is proportional to F. And another way to say this also is the fact that F equals R raised to the lift minus 1, just an indication here. This represents the lift, which in some textbooks can be represented by a cursive L, where R is a constant parameter that is a particular aspect of the valve you're using. Finally, quick opening valves are done such that the valve characteristic F is related to the square root of the lift. For a quick opening valve, what we want is, as the name indicates, is when we open the valve very slightly, a lot of flow comes out. Therefore, these valves are designed such that at low flow rates, you get more of the flow coming out, and then when the valve gets more open, you get more of a diminishing returns on it. Because of this rationale, quick opening valves are used for safety only and are not used for controlling systems. Because of this setup of trying to have very high amounts of flow very quickly, it makes it very difficult to control it at these very low openness values. So in this screencast, we have discussed some of the important information as related to control valves.